Name an effective political leader in history who couldn't speak well.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
There aren't any.
Because when it comes to a disease...
Freedom requires leadership, and leadership requires oratory. You have to speak to be heard.
I have a dream.
It's all about personal growth and guts.
Never give in. Never, never, never.
What we do is if we need that extra push over the cliff, you know what we do?
Put it up to 11.
11, exactly. One louder.
Why don't you just make 10 louder and make 10 be the top number and make that a little louder?
These go to 11.
John is going to explain the format we're going to use. You will see a panel on each side of us. John will explain that in detail. But the main thing tonight is to really have fun and enjoy yourself. You're going to get some really substantial feedback on your evaluation skills. We have a target speaker this evening, and so it'll be much similar to what you would experience in a contest with some twist to it. So let's get this party started this evening. So let's welcome our Toastmaster this evening. Actually, he's going to facilitate, and then Virginia will come back up. But let's welcome Mr. John Labby, who's the president of Top Toastmasters. John.
Thank you very much, Jerry, and I want to thank all of you for coming out and spending your evening with us in lieu of celebrating National Cheeseburger Day.
Yay!
I will have you know that I celebrated it. And if for some reason you're in a mood to celebrate, tomorrow happens to be National Talk Like a Pirate Day.
Arr.
2 days later, Big Whopper Liar Day, which would be a fabulous day to run a Tall Tales contest. One of my favorites, national holidays, is coming up on the 24th, and that is National Punctuation Day. And I'm sure somebody in the room is going to like this one. On the 27th, National Hug a Vegetarian Day. We are going to have some fun tonight, as Jerry said. We're going to be focusing on how to do evaluations that meet the expectations of your contest judges. I am going to be giving a presentation, as you can see on the agenda, and I will get into our format a little bit during that presentation. But for now, I'd like to turn the floor over to our Toastmaster for the evening, Virginia Bosserman.
And thank you for coming out tonight. I know you all turned off your cell phones. I do want to check and make sure, is Raj Shaw or Mary Horgan here and didn't sign in? Okay, so we have two less people than we thought. All right. So what we're going to do tonight, we are not having a contest. So everybody breathe. It's just practice. This is for fun. It's good. It's good. You are going to have the same criteria. So your evaluation will be 2 to 3 minutes. Iqbal is going to be our timer, and he has some lovely cards here, and he's sitting right in the front. So 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes, 3 minutes. Or fast, we'll do it without the numbers show. I'll let you figure that out. So that will be just like the contest. You do not have to leave the room. You get to stay here and listen to everyone get their evaluation. So if you're going to change your evaluation based on that, good luck to you that you can remember when you get up here. I would go with what you already have. You will get 6 evaluations yourself. You guys have hit the jackpot tonight. Because we have 2 panels here of 3 people, and you will get 2 different categories that each person is going to do 1 category of your speech. And of course, now I can't remember the categories.
That's okay. John will cover
that during his presentation on what the judges are going to be looking for in the contest, which when you think about it, is a really good concept. Don't you want to know what they're going to be looking for when you do your evaluation. Okay, so that will really help you. And then listening, not only will you learn from what people tell you about what you said and the comments that you made, but then you'll also learn from hearing what they're telling other people, because sometimes it's easier to see it when somebody else does it than when we do it. And then of course we have Tim here, who has been gracious enough to come out and tape, and then he told you how you can get a hold of your copy. Great, because I don't do the techie stuff. Technology and I are not having a good week. All right, so are we ready, Mr. Labby? All right, I would like to introduce John Labby. And he didn't give me a bio, so I just get to make stuff up about him. But I do remember a few things. He is president of our club, and he's doing a fine job. As an officer, I could say that. We all love him. He was the Northwest Division governor last year. This year, he is the club extension chair. If you don't know what that is, that's the person who does the organizing for starting new clubs. And so if you have an idea for a new club, you may hear from Mr. Labby. He'd be happy to come out with his team and do a demo meeting for you. John is an expert trainer. He has written a book, of which I have read, but I am loath to remember the title. On the bottom. Random Wisdom Connections, Reflections for Speakers, Teachers, and Trainers. It's an ebook, and it's available at Amazon.com, and I would highly recommend it. It's got some great, good ideas in there. He's been a Toastmaster since 2004, and he has done a lot of trainings. He's a professional trainer, has been a trainer for many years, and he has done a lot of the trainings for the judges. For instance, when I went to the TLI, I went to his session on judging. So he is very familiar with the criteria. And I think that that's going to be excellent for you and excellent for all of us. So without any further ado, Mr. John Labby.
Thank you very much, Virginia. If I stand roughly here, can everyone see the screen? Do we need to lower the lights in any way?
Steve, you okay in the back?
Good.
Everybody can see all right? All right. So I need to be able to see what we're doing now. All right, let's talk briefly about what we're about here. In the next 10 minutes, I would like to focus with you on what it is the judges actually look for during the evaluation contest. We're going to look closely at the judging criteria, what they mean, and make an attempt to translate that into what you should be doing when performing an evaluation, at least during a contest, which are somewhat different from the evaluations we do in a club. I'm sure everybody would agree. So the way judging usually works is the judges have a ballot. Does everybody have a copy of the ballot? We were handing them out. If not, please raise your pinky and Virginia will make sure you get one. So what usually happens is judges have this ballot, and at the top of the ballot are a set of criteria with a suggested scoring system. Most judges follow this, but not all. Some just sort of use their gut feel. However, let's look at how these criteria break out. Analytical quality is 40% of the picture. 40% of the points in the scoring system on that ballot are for analytical quality. So that's the quality of the thinking behind your evaluation and the quality of the things that you point out. We'll talk a little bit more in a moment. 30% is for the nature of the recommendations, the actual, you should be doing these kinds of things in your next speech kinds of things. And then 30% broken up or divided between the technique, which is your approach and personality, if you will, and the summation, which is the end of the evaluation. Those That breakout matters, and we're going to look at that. So analytical quality, these are the criteria, the breakdown on the back of the judge's ballot. The evaluation should be clear and focused, should refer to the evaluation should be effective, whatever that means. There's a little bit of open road there. It should identify specific strengths and weaknesses of that particular speech and should be presented clearly and logically. All right, recommendations. We're going to go through this pretty quickly because we want to get to the meat of the business. The recommendations should be positive, specific, and helpful. There should be specific ways to improve, right? Practical, helpful, and enable the speaker to improve the very next presentation. So many times we watch an evaluation and the recommendations would be fabulous for somebody who's this close to being a paid professional speaker, but not necessarily applicable for somebody who has done 5 whole speeches in Toastmasters and was petrified when they did their first speech. The recommendations really ought to be about where this speaker is right now. That's what that point's about. Technique is about being sympathetic, sensitive, motivational. It's about being sensitive to the feelings and the needs of the speaker and should inspire and encourage. That's what technique is expected. That's the technique that is expected. And then summation should be concise, should be clear, encouraging, and more than anything else, there should be one. The summation is 15% of the points that are available. So if you don't have a summation, best you can do, folks, is a B. And Bs don't usually win contests, just so you know. All right, you only have 150 seconds. That's 2 minutes, 30 seconds. I suppose I should have said you have 149, but you have 150, so long as the timer has a really, really quick finger. And here's how things break out. If you were to use the point value weighting from the judge's ballot, from the scoring guide, you would allow 71 seconds for analysis, 52 seconds for recommendations, and 27 seconds for the summation. Here's how I figured this, put this together. Technique is about everything in the evaluation. So if we divide out, if we take out those 15 points and then recalculate the percentages based on the remaining 85 points, this is what you get. Now, I'm not here to recommend that your evaluation follow a strict set of guidelines like this. There's art to doing an evaluation. You have to be yourself. However, something that I can tell you I have observed many, 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 many times is a speaker doing an evaluation will spend 2.5 minutes or more on analysis, and maybe 30 seconds or so on recommendations. Something tells me that if those evaluators expanded the recommendation portion, the end result would be stronger. Something to think about. So use your time wisely. You have 5 minutes after the completion of the target speech to organize your notes. Presumably, you've been taking notes furiously during the target speech, and your work during that 5 minutes is about identifying the most important, most pertinent things to discuss in your analysis of the speech, and the most important and pertinent ideas to recommend in your recommendations, and some sense of sequence. Then, during the evaluation itself, you want to be applying the time as wisely as you can. Remember, you have 150 seconds. 2 years ago, maybe it was three, I was attending a lot of area contests, and something started to bug me. And it was the way that evaluation contestants would open up their evaluations with all sorts of flowery praise for the target speaker. A thousand thanks for having the courage to stand up before all these wonderful people and yada, blah, blah. So I started timing. Time to content. And what I found was that more times than not, the evaluators who got to the meat of it soonest finished highest in the contest. Think about it. If you waste 30 seconds on making nice to the target speaker, that's 30 seconds you don't have to do coaching. That's 30 seconds you don't have to show your analysis and to show the caliber of your recommendations. So the protocols can suck up a lot of time. Yes, you need to greet everyone in the room. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and especially Bill. What did that take? 7 or 8 seconds? Maybe. And yes, at the end, you need to pass control back to the contest Toastmaster. But that takes 3 or 4 seconds. So you still have around 140 seconds of your own time if you keep your protocol time to a minimum. You need to use as much time as possible in order to get in as many points as possible during the evaluation. So please, use minimum time for protocol. Oh, and I would be really careful of the fillers. Fillers, to me, are the praise of the target speaker, talking about the speech. You know what? There are 50 people in the room, and they just saw the very same speech. And not only that, but the speaker who gave it was there too. So giving up 60 seconds to say, so I love that you did this, and you did this, and you did this. What, this guy got nothing to say? Does he not understand the purpose of these 3 minutes? So use your time. Use it for analysis and recommendations, not for donuts. All right, just a quick off-the-wall idea. In my view, evaluations, giving evaluations, is the closest thing that we have in Toastmasters to teaching. We evaluators, we are the only teachers in the system. This is where the teaching happens. So if that's the case, then I suggest that our evaluations should look a lot like teaching. And here's a simple definition of teaching. Teaching is the facilitation of learning from experience. Learning from experience. The experience in this case is somebody gives a speech, right? And here's what happens in the learning cycle. You have an experience, and if you then pay attention to what happened, meaning you look at all possible feedback, and then reflect on that feedback, reflect on what happened. That allows you to make plans to do a better job next time. So as an evaluator, your role is to facilitate this, to make sure that this happens. You come in at the attention point. You raise the pertinent feedback that is most likely to allow this speaker to be able to make good plans that he or she is capable of executing in their next speech. So you provide the feedback and you make suggestions, the recommendations, for what ought to be planned for the next speech. So you are facilitating the learning from experience. So, I just made a big deal about the summation. I have one too. So by all means, know and study the criteria. By all means, use your time wisely. And as Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young sort of said, teach your speaker well. Now, let me explain briefly what's going to happen in terms of these criteria. As you saw, there are four sections of judging criteria. Analytical quality, which represents 40%, recommendations, which represents 30% of the point value, and then the technique and the summation combine to also represent 30%. So what we have done is the six members of Toastmasters on Purpose who are here, who are not otherwise occupied, so that the otherwise occupied are Tim and Virginia. So the remaining six of us have each signed on to observe only one of those criteria. So two of us are going to be looking uniquely and only at the analytical quality of each evaluation. Two of us are going to be looking at the recommendations that each evaluator makes. And then two of us are going to be looking at the technique and summation as a pair of judging criteria. So after our target speaker has concluded, I think we'll probably take a couple of minutes so that the evaluators can begin to organize their thoughts. The rest of us will get to go hit the food bar or just stretch our legs for a couple of minutes. Then when we reconvene, we're going to go through our evaluator candidates in the order that they appear on your program and on your agenda. I think we have one or two are missing.
Yes.
And then after each of the evaluators has concluded, they'll return to their seats, and then Virginia will facilitate about 6 or 7 minutes of coaching from the members of Toastmasters on Purpose. So roughly a minute each from six different people on the three groups of categories. Make sense? Let's go.
All right, anybody who has to go to the bathroom very quickly while John shuts it down, this is your 30-second warning.
Good.
All right. I don't have any funny stories. Sorry.
Mm-hmm. What happened with technology?
I'm telling you, I'm having a bad week with technology.
There's
yeah.
a story there.
There's a story there. Oh, 160,000 clients reloaded over the weekend. And there were a few glitches. Can't do quotes, can't do invoices. What? So they went from not-for-profit to for-profit? They want to make some money? What's up with that? Yeah, so I've had some long hours this week. Like I said, I have a love-hate relationship with technology.
Don't you work for Underwriters Laboratories, too?
I do. Yes, and I'm not an engineer. I don't get to blow anything up. It's not any fun at all. All right, but we are privileged to have a target speaker here tonight. I'd like to introduce Beth Reed, Confidence is ours. Beth Reed, confidence is ours.
Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests, which includes me, we humans are impressed by a confident person. That person has it all together. That person is certain. That person is in control of their destiny. I only wish I was so assured and so certain, our inner voice whispers. We seek out certainty as a state, knowing where we are, what's expected of us, where we're going. This is comfort to us. Meeting these criteria makes us confident. The problem is, it's really hard for us to meet these criteria. Therefore, we rarely feel confident. How many of you are old enough to remember Jack Palance and his little bit about confidence is sexy, don't you think? One or two. He was old. He was a has-been. He came back out of nowhere, and he captured our attention for a few months, for a few minutes. Remember? There's a mental equation, and it goes something like control plus certainty equals confidence. The problem with that is that how much control do we really have? Very little control over external forces. The weather, institutions, other people, and so on. What if we thought about it all differently? What if certainty and control came along because we act confident? What if the people who appear confident in public are really just as nervous, just as worried, as ill-prepared, basically jelly in the middle, just like the rest of us? I learned a little something about this from my younger son when he was in first grade. He could work a room full of his classmates like a polished statesman. I was so impressed. But I knew he was jelly inside. This really made me think. Look at the animal world for other examples of the way acting confident makes a difference. Animals, many animals, have a method of getting bigger and more amazing, large. They use this method when they feel threatened. We can adapt that for our own purposes. We don't have to feel threatened. When we are feeling uncertain and timid, we get smaller and shrink into place. Maybe we should do the opposite and expand. Try it in your seat now. Take up more space. Fill up the space that you're in. Psychologists say that these are power poses. And they have done research that proves that we can feel different. The way that we feel will change based on these poses. Let's do it again. Straighten your spine, square your shoulders, head up, open up, okay? Let's add words. Using confident words makes a big difference in our sense of confidence. Where would you try this? I wouldn't recommend going for the big splash right off the bat. Go for a couple of small wins. Build up to that bigger thing. Then the equation becomes confidence helps us understand what we can control and strengthens our feeling of certainty. Wherever you decide to try this, make sure that you have a place that you can do your power pose and take a deep breath. Square your shoulders, lift your chin, and stride out. I am feeling confident that you can meet this challenge. Madam Toastmaster.
Mr. Timer, could you give us 3 minutes for all of you to go through your notes and prepare for your evaluation?
And the rest of us.
You need to take ownership of your career. You need to invest in yourself, on your self-development.
2 reasons to join Toastmasters. You and me. You will improve yourself, your confidence level, and be an overall better person. And your improvement will improve my experience around you.
So if you'd like to build confidence, join Toastmasters.
Motivation to improve myself.
Leadership.
Teamwork.
Enrichment.
Fearless.
Courage.
Connect with an audience.
Self-confidence.
Friendship.
Transformation.
Become a better listener.
Success.
Toastmasters. Our first contestant is going to be Kathy Biederstaff. Our second contestant will be Paul Lockwood. Our third evaluator will be Mei Lee. Then we will have a short break. And then our next contestant will be Eric Hattenhauer, Emily Horowitz, Jerry Evans, and Nick Bellantuano. Okay, do you need another minute? Are you ready? Okay.
Can I repeat that one more time?
I will repeat it one more time, yes. Our first evaluator will be Kathy Biederstaff. Our second evaluator will be Paul Lockwood. Our third evaluator will be Mei Lee. We'll have a break, and then first up after the break will be Eric Hattenhauer, Emily Horowitz, Jerry Evans, and Nick Bellantuano.
Beth, thank you for coming out tonight. I appreciate it. There are a couple things that I noticed right off, and that is your choice of topic was wonderful, in my opinion, because you were speaking to your audience. We're all here to improve ourselves, and when you speak of confidence, you speak to the reason we're all here, which was a good thing. And I also really, a friend of mine saw the Stones a couple months ago when they were in town, and when he left the concert, he called me and he said, "I feel like Mick Jagger was singing right to me. Now I know his popularity." And when you were speaking tonight, I felt the same way. I felt that in a great way you were speaking to me, because you were telling me things that I like to hear. I did find a few distractions. And one of them is that when you came out really strong. And you came out forcefully using your voice and your body gestures. And then you kind of backed down, and then you got strong again, and then you went, and then you backed down. I feel like I am most affected by speeches that, in your own words, small wins that lead to big things. If you start out slowly and you work your way up to a crescendo, and then you work your way back down, and I mean in gestures, in adverbs, in adjectives, in your vocal volume, and in the amount of space you take, I have to read my notes.
That's fine.
I put my glasses on. I really like the fact that you use metaphors. Metaphors help people, especially me. I'm a visual thinker. Help me visualize things. You said your son spoke like a statesman to a room full of classmates. I could picture that. And I like the way you demonstrated the way animals enlarge themselves to threaten. That helped me remember things, and then to really drive the point home, you had us all participate, which is a real hands-on thing, which is really good. So I think that if you were to focus your tone and your strength, build it up, bring it back down, so you have a climax in there, a notable climax, and then you wrap things up at the end, and work your gestures and your volume with that, I think you're going to have a lot more effect. Okay, thank you.
Now you, Kathy, will get to be evaluated. So, we'll start on this side, if I can remember, right, left. And who's going to do the analytical quality? Okay, Val.
Thank you, Kathy. In evaluating your evaluation, your strength, you identified the strengths of the speaker, and you came out right away. You didn't spend a lot of time with complimenting the speaker, but actually complimenting her topic, which was good. So choice of the speaker, the speaker is speaking to you, you identified that as a strength. You also identified that you liked the metaphors. And the way you structured it first is you had a couple of strengths that you recommend, that you identified strengths, and then you went to the weakness. And you identified what was distracting to you, which again you went back to what you liked and made a few more comments about the metaphors, about the demonstration that she did of the animals, and then the driving the point home. So I think the way you structured it was effective. It was clear. I know you did lose a little time with looking at your notes. So I would have, your glasses on, or looking at your notes. The focus, you were focused on what you were going to recommend to the speaker. And I would say the strengths, again, mention more strengths.
Okay, great. Thanks, Carol. All right, and who's doing analytical quality on this side? Jerry Evans.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster and Kathy. Your strengths in the beginning is that you got right to the point in terms of good evening, Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters. Then you segued into thank you for coming out tonight. I'm not so sure that was necessarily necessary. I think you could, again, just since you got right into it. Similar to what Val said, talking about you thought that the choice of topic was good, and that we're all here to improve ourselves. So you were focusing on her strengths right off the bat and reinforcing it. You didn't use anything in between, it wasn't fluffy, and so I think that was good that you got right to the meat of what her speech was about. Similar again to what Val said in terms of you started talking about few distractions and then related that to what distracts you for you as a speaker. Her notes, your notes were a little bit distracting, so I think you could actually do without the notes. I'm sure that'll come up in recommendations, but I think that took away from your evaluation. And so it's a reminder for what you're evaluating, but I think you could dispense with that. In terms of your strengths, in terms of talking about her metaphors, also her lack of, or she didn't use a lot of filler words, or you didn't use a lot of filler words, and then recommendations, you had specific recommendations in terms of how she can improve her speech. You kind of wrapped it up, and then also I would suggest, again, as you were giving her suggestions, just to stay on point with that. Because I think that...
That's me.
I'm sorry. But your recommendations in general and her areas for improvement, I think that's the biggest strength that you have, because you cut right to the chase. You didn't waste a lot of time with all the filler stuff. And then just in terms of using your notes, again, put your glasses on, as Val has already suggested, or just have an outline of the points that you want to cover for the evaluation.
Great. Side of the room and have our first evaluator for recommendations. Nick?
Yes. Kathy, I thought you gave some very good recommendations. You talked and went into a little bit of a personal story. You mentioned the Rolling Stones, which I thought was good. The one thing you might want to try next time is you said that you connected to Beth when she was giving your speech and made you think of the Rolling Stone concert. What was it that she was doing at those moments that made you connect to her? Because it was a little general, because all that was said is, I connected to you. So just a little bit more specifics. And you did that when you mentioned the metaphors. I liked when you went into the metaphors with your son. And you went into dislikes when she went a little soft of vocal variety. So every time you mention like or dislike, just give a little more explanation why. But other than that, I thought it was great.
Great. Now to this side of the room, and John
yes.
will give his version of
so recommendations. So Kathy, let's talk recommendations. The strengths in this evaluation, at least in terms of the recommendations, were that you gave several. A couple things, though, that I would have done differently, I think, or that you could do differently. One is, I sense that it was a little brief, that the amount of time dedicated to the recommendation part of your evaluation might have been a little, could have been longer. The other thing that I was looking for that I didn't hear was specific ties to things that Beth did or said with your recommendation. So, for example, you recommended that she focus her tone and vary that. And I'm not 100% sure what is it about her speech you were recommending she change. So, if I didn't quite follow it, I wonder if perhaps the speaker might have similar difficulty following somewhat generic or general recommendations. So I would tie the recommendations more cleanly to specifics in the speech.
Thank you, John. Okay. And next we'll have Amy doing technique and summation.
Thank you. Good evening, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and most welcome guests, dignitaries, and most importantly, Kathy. Kathy, I had the opportunity to evaluate your technique and summation of your evaluation, and I first of all want to start out by praising you, because one of the first things I want to share is I really appreciate the fact that you generally have a positive demeanor and you have a very warm, friendly demeanor when you are engaging with us, and especially during your evaluation. So it makes it motivating to the speaker. And the other piece that I really appreciated was that you did a nice job of balance. You balanced the strengths as well as the areas that Beth could potentially look at to improve to make her speech even more effective the next time that she delivers it. Another thing that I appreciated about the technique is when you summarized at the end of the speech, you used this hand gesture and you kind of said to do these techniques and then come back down. And I thought, wow, that's a really interesting way to try to wrap the whole speech up. Some of the areas that I might suggest to focus on a little more is you're summarizing the speech. One of the things I said earlier is you're very positive, you're warm, you're friendly, but I think maybe tightening up just a little bit, maybe using a little bit more concise language and pausing and just enunciating the words a little bit more when you're delivering that final recommendation to the speaker about what suggestions you'd like to make to them. I also wanted to share that I noticed the eye contact a little bit. You seem to be looking a little bit more towards the speaker and maybe once in a while kind of looking at the audience and sharing these evaluation recommendations that all of us might be able to use as well the next time we speak might make your evaluation effective as well. Thank you.
Thanks, Amy. And then we have John Peschel.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, guests, most importantly, Kathy. A couple things that I noticed in your technique that I picked up on that I really liked and it would be really motivational for the speaker is that you used I feel statements when you were giving recommendations and thought you weren't saying you could have done this, you could have done that. You were saying, I feel this. And so it wasn't as confrontational. And it would give a better feel to the person getting those recommendations. And I thought that was a very strong technique that you used. And it seemed real natural. So I'm sure it's not the first time that you've used those type of statements. That was really good. The other thing that I saw is your summation, and I know that Amy mentioned the sweeping arm motion, that was good. I felt like you were rushing through the summation, almost like you saw the yellow card go up, and you're like, oh, I better summarize real quick. And so there wasn't that real concise summation that I think you probably wanted to give.
Okay, great, thank you. Our next contestant is Paul Lockwood. Our next evaluator.
There we go.
Is Paul Lockwood.
Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, guests, and especially Beth. Confidence is ours. I think you had us from the title. I think as soon as the Toastmaster said that, we're thinking, I can be confident. I can feel confident. And I saw you immediately take control of this space, and that was a real strength. I thought, here's someone who has a strong message, and they know where they are, they're confident, they feel comfortable where they are. You immediately started with gestures, another strength. You were counting on your hands, and for a while there, you kept them pretty much at waist level. And I thought, might want to go a little bigger. But it wasn't too long before you were way up here, and you were bringing us up, and you were bringing us to widen in our chairs. Another strength, the acting. As a community theater actor myself, I sense that you have a way to get emotion across. And you did that very well, I thought. And you involved the audience. I think as soon as you can involve the audience, not just listening, but paying close enough attention that we are moving in our chairs, we are saying things, we are moving our arms, you've got the audience in the palm of your hands, literally. A couple of things I suggest you work on. Memorization. If you're going to do a memorized speech but you're not 100% sure that you've got it entirely memorized, perhaps keep the notes a little closer to where you are. Coming all the way over here to get those notes kept too large a gap. Pauses, and perhaps this is a little bit connected with memorization, but when you pause, pause for effect. Pause because you want us to think about something. Not necessarily because we think you don't know what the next word is that you're going to say. And perhaps that might have been the case, but exude the confidence that you're talking about. Final suggestion, use more of the space. I think you were within about a 2-foot by 4-foot area here. Come out. Come out to us. Bring us in even more. Especially in the part where you were saying stride out. That would have been a perfect opportunity to actually stride out into the audience here. Get us in the palm of your hand, keep us there. I am feeling confident. Those four words, I think, are a mantra to you and can be as you go forward. Work on the pauses, work on the memorization, use more of the space, and keep the strengths that you have. Madam Toastmaster.
Thank you, Paul. All right, now we're going to start on this side of the room, just to be fair. And so our first person will be Jerry Evans, doing the analytical quality. Jerry?
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and certainly Paul. Madam Toastmaster, we got right into it. You have a very clear, strong, assured voice. Your confidence came through in terms of your evaluating right off the beginning, and you also complimented Beth on reinforcing the title of her speech, which tied into some of the suggestions that you made to Beth. And you gave us specific examples about the gestures that Beth used in her speech. So that was a good strength of yours. You also talked about acting and how to get her point across. I think maybe that ties back to some of the background that you have, because you also demonstrated that to the audience and also gave her an example of that. I thought that was excellent. One thing you brought to the mix, one of your strengths, is just your energy. You are animated. And so that came across in your evaluation. And you gave her specifics in terms of the memorization and how she could utilize that as a technique. And then you gave her another example of notes and how she could get better at that so it wouldn't be distracting to the audience, another strength. And a final suggestion. So there were a lot of different things that you did, but you demonstrated a lot of the examples, and you're very clear and focused about what she could do to improve her speech. So excellent job.
Our next version of the analytical quality would be Val Fuson.
Paul, I like the way you came out with a lot of energy, a lot of strength, and you kept very good eye contact with Beth. You were clear with what you were going to talk to her about. You had a good layout, a good structure, and you stayed on point with it. The strengths you were talking to her about, her strength, and I like the way you identified her strength, why it was effective, and how it affected you. You mentioned about the weaknesses. Well, mainly in the recommendations is where you identified the weaknesses. You didn't give some other points where they could improve, and then make the recommendations. So there might be some room there to find out what they could improve on besides the suggestions. And picking one or two recommendations is all that's needed. You were very focused, and I think the way you laid out your evaluation would be effective for the speaker to grow.
On to recommendations, John
Lovey. All right. Paul. Where are you, Paul? There you are. Thank you. All right. I really liked two elements of your recommendations. One is, first of all, I agreed with them. They are pretty much the ones that I would have given. But more importantly, every single recommendation you gave is something that Beth would be able to do tomorrow. She's perfectly capable of following those instructions. The other thing that I liked especially well was that one of your recommendations, the idea of using space and using space more broadly and that kind of thing, was directly connected to something that you identified as a strength. I don't know that you said it quite that way, but I really liked seeing evaluations that not only provide recommendations for improvement in areas that were weak, but hey, look, here's a strength of yours, here's how to move it up a notch. You know, kick it up a notch, as Emerald would say. So those are two elements that I thought were really strong in your recommendations.
Excellent. Thank you. All right. And on to technique, Amy Smatos. I skipped Nick.
Nah,
I'm sorry,
Nick.
Okay. I'm sorry. Nick Bell.
Paul, I did what John said. I really liked your evaluation. I think some of the points you brought up were very practical, but like John said, something you could do tomorrow. I really liked what you said about gestures, and you gave her specific examples for how she counted on her fingers, but then how she got wide, and it kind of showed the confidence. I thought what you said about notes was right on. When it creates a barrier, it takes away from the speech, so I thought that was great advice. I thought your comment about pauses was a very good recommendation. The only thing I would say to improve upon is your recommendation was so good that I'm concerned that the summation didn't emphasize it. So at the end, a little bit more, one, remember your gestures, two, remember to memorize your speech in preparation, and three, pause for effect, just so that gets reinforced, because I thought it was so effective. But the other thing is you want it to connect to the speaker so they can use it next time. Well, other than that, I thought it was great. Thank you.
John Peschel will give us the technique and summation.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster. Paul, having heard you speak, being a member of the club previously with you, your evaluation touched your community theater, and I thought it was very motivational for the speaker in that you gave her exact things that she could do in her next speech. And as a speaker, when I have something that I can use in my next speech, that gets me excited about giving my next speech, because I can put that into practice and get better and better. So I really enjoyed that part of it. Specifically the coming up and engaging the audience and connecting them, using the space, those types of things. The summary was very concise. I did hear you count three or four things, and maybe if you were able to get a little more time in that, maybe expand that a little bit, but it was still, you still had the 4 points, maybe add a little depth to each of those, so a quick sentence.
Thank you. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and Paul, most importantly. Paul, I evaluated your technique and summation also, and I first of all want to identify some of the strengths that I saw. Number one, your delivery is outstanding. When you said that you were an actor, I instantly picked up on that because I know if I was sitting in the back of the room, I could have heard you very well. You have a powerful voice. You've got great intonation. Your gestures also were powerful and meaningful. And you also, one thing I also appreciated is that when you did give the suggestions at the end of the speech, you just did it one, two, three, you know, pauses, and you got right to the point, and you made it really easy for Beth because she didn't have to sift through a lot of different words and descriptions. You just got right to the point, and I thought it was really strong and effective. Some of the areas that I might suggest to focus on to make your evaluation even more effective, number one, You're so powerful that one thing I would like to see you do more of is smile and just kind of take a breath, have a good time. And I know that that's something I have to remind myself to do once in a while, but a little bit more variety in the emotions. So smiling and at some points being more enunciated with the fist and the hand gesture or the power, but also relax a little bit more. You seemed a little bit tense. I know this is a large group and you're in front of a lot of us here, but I think that would have been a little more effective just to breathe and let go a little bit. And I look forward to seeing your next evaluation. Thank you.
Our next evaluation for Beth will be from May Lee. May Lee.
I am confident. I am confident. Does that best speech remind you of Sound of Music? Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, and welcome guests, especially back. I think you are a wonderful motivational speaker. I can see you are a rising star. Speaking in front of the high school students, telling them how to improve their self-confidence and be successful in their life. Thank you very much for coming up and give such a wonderful speech. I would like to mention some of your speaking strength in four different ways. And initial that would be B-E-T-H. B is your breathing. I think you have a wonderful pause during your speech. Your breathing really helped about from time to time. You gave us some opportunity to think about your message. And the E is entertaining. Your great gestures, your pointing fingers, your big arms up here, and your pace a little bit from back to the front, left to the right, really make us feel entertained. Do you all agree?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Now T is the timing. I think you gave quite a few different way of the timing in terms of when you ask the audience participate in your speech and practice that motto of saying, I am feeling confident. I think you really make us feel that way. And then the next one is H. It's hands-on, audience involvement. I always love the speaker who can involve, include the audience, and really make the message cross because they are practicing it by speaking, by exercising it. Wonderful, wonderful speech. In my humble opinions, there are a few areas that maybe you can improve in your future speech. And this one particularly, and I summarize as a P-A-P-A. First P is pacing. I noticed that you pretty much stay in this area. I would love to see you go to the left corner and to the right, especially when you're trying to pick up the notes. You can just maybe casually walk over. So pacing will be helpful. A is when you do the audience involvement, try to ask them, maybe encourage them to stand up. Not only get some exercise and get some move that maybe take it to the next level. Another P is personal story. You touch a little bit about sharing your son's experience. I would love to see you extend that a little bit more and tell the audience how the confidence helped your son and his friend's life. Why it's so important that we have to have a good confidence. I would like to see that personal story always connect the audience. Last A for improvement is about the closing. I would like to see that you ask audience to take action. Call to action. Maybe stop when you have everybody stand up and say, I am feeling confidence, and just end right there, because you've already got your message crossed. In summary, this is a wonderful speech. You have the strength of BETH, and I'd love to see you improve by pacing, asking audience, have some more involvements, bigger gestures, and then have some more personal stories to share. I'm looking forward to your next speech.
So our first evaluation of Mei Li will be on analytical quality, and this time it will be Val Pisa. Val?
Mei Li, I loved your energy when you came out. I think you acknowledged the speaker right away, but I think you demonstrated some of the speaker's qualities that you were going to tell her about. So I like the way you started out. So you had a good opening, and then you went into the structure. You used two different ways of with the strengths, and then also the improvement. You used abbreviations for that, and that's one way to structure your speech, which is a nice way to do that. I like that. You identify the strengths and the delivery. You also talked to her about her delivery, her timing, and the audience involvement. So those were all good recommendations or strengths that she has already that you identified that she has. You also went into the weaknesses. You could also word the weaknesses or something as other strengths that you have that you could even improve even more. And then you talked about 4 points, the pacing. What I liked is that you identified what you wanted to recommend to her, or the strengths and the weaknesses. You always identified what it was, and then you told her how she could improve it. The presentation was effective, I believe. It could be even more effective if you only had 1 to 2 recommendations instead of 4. I don't know about the timing, but I would go into more detail on the things that she's doing well, because some things she's doing well could also be improved. We can always take our best strength to another level. But if you're going to identify 4 parts to improve, it's going to be hard for her to remember that, because she can only practice 1 or 2 things for the next speech. So I would say identify the most effective 1 or 2 points that's going to change her speech immediately. Okay. And so, but it was a very good presentation.
More analysis?
Yes, thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and Mei Li. Strong, confident, strong opening. You really open with a bang. Talk about energy, enthusiasm, excitement, bam, you hit it right away. Acknowledging Beth and using the acronym with her name, that was excellent, because that's a way to capture and engage the audience and make them pay attention to your evaluation, because you structured it almost like a story. And it became, when you got to the part about entertaining, you were entertaining as an evaluator. So I give you a double lead for that. That was strong. You talked about engagement, including the audience. So using her name as an acronym, and then focusing on her strengths. And then when you got to the back end of it, and using another acronym, you got a little bit long with that. I'm sure that will be covered in recommendations. But even using that, because then to point out best areas that she can improve. Some of the points were long, but I think shortening that, but just using that, I think that's a strong technique that also separates you as an evaluator apart from somebody else that perhaps might give a traditional evaluation. But coming out in the beginning to really capture everybody's attention with that energy and enthusiasm, bam, you hit it strong.
Thank you, Madam Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, and especially Mei Li. Mei Li, I really liked your recommendations. I feel I like what you did with the acronyms. you mentioned a lot of things that Beth did well, using the B, TH. The thing that I would like to perhaps see next time is with the PAPA, that's eight letters, that's a lot to keep in mind. But as far as your recommendations, I thought they were good. You mentioned pacing, you mentioned audience involvement, you mentioned to take action. But perhaps maybe just use the acronym on the Beth side, and then when you get to improvements, you don't necessarily have to do an acronym because it may not have related in this point. But as far as the things that you said, I think you called her for doing a strong action to try to get the audience involved. So I thought it was very good. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and Maylee. I liked a couple of things about your recommendations in this evaluation. One, first off, they were very specific, very practical, absolutely doable on Beth's next speech. That was terrific. And they're exceptionally well organized. Maybe almost a little too much so, as Nick suggested. On the other hand, they were all very good, very useful recommendations. So that's a plus. I would suggest a couple of things that could have been improved. One is the word pacing usually refers to the speed with which we speak. And if it doesn't refer to that, it refers to, as you were using it, walking back and forth. But for most of us, if we hear pacing, we think of it as a negative because it's something we don't want to do. We don't want to be just randomly pacing. We want to be commanding a space on the stage, moving to another space, and so on. Which is, I think, where you were going, but the word choice might have been improved. And the other is I would look for ways to be a little more concise about the recommendations. Strong as they were, they perhaps could have been condensed just a touch.
John, thank you. Amy is going to give us the technique and summation
advantage. Sure. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and May, there you are. I wanted to first of all share that I love your natural enthusiasm and your positive energy and your positive attitude. So you nailed it as far as being sympathetic and motivating to Beth, our target speaker tonight. Some of the other components that I really appreciated about your evaluation is that you not only praised Beth, but you also called her motivational speaker, which I thought, wow, what a compliment that is. And I agree with you on that. I think she's got some natural tendencies towards that. So it really instantly filled her cup, and I'm sure she's going to want to give another motivational speech after that. I also like the fact that you did a nice balance. You focused the first portion of your speech on the areas that you praised that she was doing extremely well, and then you saved the last part of the speech for more of the constructive suggestions. And as my fellow evaluators would probably agree, I love the acronyms that you used too, because it made it easy for all of us to follow, and I'm sure Beth can probably remember those as well. Some of the strengths that you have, in addition to the high energy using the speaking area, you really moved around. You didn't stand in one place the whole time, and you just brought your energy out to all of us in the audience. Some areas I might suggest to focus on to make your evaluations even more effective is that the great thing about having energy is there's a lot of enthusiasm, but the flip side of that is to try to breathe, take a breath, and draw that energy in just a little bit so that we can kind of track where you're going and follow. It's a little bit easier for the audience. Also, your speaking voice, I can hear you really well up here, but I think that if you did draw it in a little bit more and projected that voice to the back of the room, especially if you're in a district event or a division event, you would want to make sure that everybody else can hear you. But outside of that, I enjoyed your evaluation, and I look forward to hearing your next one. Thank you.
Sure. Maylee, thank you. I'm going to mention the acronym again. That was brilliant.
This is my first time trying.
And here's why. Dale Carnegie said, nothing sounds sweeter than a person's own name. I'm going to bet you Beth will never forget that acronym. That was brilliant. It also, it would help you remember the points you made for when you're summarizing, you can run through them because Beth is an easy acronym to remember, especially if it's her name. The summation, the time seemed to get away from you, and I don't know what the exact time was. I'm going to guess it was quite a bit longer than it needed to be. And just break down the whole evaluation, especially when you're in a contest situation, unlike tonight.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right, Mr. Tyler, can you give us 5 minutes for a quick break? And you may help yourself to some more food, some washrooms.
And going forward, we're... let me get my notes here.
Jazz, you need Irvine Toastmasters.
Oh, is this Toastmasters?
It is, welcome. Hi, I'm Michelle.
Thank you, my name's Jazz. My boss told me to come here.
Come on, Jazz.
Me?
How are you going to spend your summer vacation this year?
What was the question again?
And you will create impact. We can create a winning PSA.
And now let's welcome our best speaker of the season, Mr. Jazz Salcedo.
And that's a summary of our fourth quarter earnings. Well done, Jazz. Thank you, Michael. And I owe it all to Irvine Toastmasters.
You had a nice little break. We're going to try to pick up the pace a little bit. And one of the things that we're going to do to help not waste time so that you can all get home in a reasonable hour is if you may clap for the evaluator who comes up to evaluate Beth. But you can refrain from clapping for the panel because
Yay.
That's another 30 seconds. Except for the heckler in the second row. All right. So I hope that Eric is ready to go. All right. Our next evaluator will be Eric Hattenhauer. Eric?
Beth, confidence is ours. In that speech, confidence was yours. From the beginning, you gave us a simple, straightforward objective. To give us confidence. To walk away feeling good about ourselves and being prepared to tackle one thing at a time, building us up to be that persona that you started off with. It didn't feel like you. You were giving us that character, that person that we all look to and go, yeah, that person's confident. And at the same time, you also gave us some features. You gave us the times when we cringe and we mentally feel that lack of confidence. So from the beginning to end, you did a great job of creating audience interaction and audience adaptation, making sure that you drew us in. It was with the personas, it was with your vocal variety, and it was with the examples. You did an excellent job with one, the adaptation with those examples, and two, really bringing us into the speech. When you got us thinking about our posture in our seats, when you got us saying, I am confident, I feel confident, you brought us in. That was a crescendo right there. And then, when you started to transition into your thesis, I was all energized, but I didn't know what to do with it. I would have loved for you to help me out a little bit, tell me what were those small obstacles, those small challenges that you tackled to build up that confidence. I was ready. I knew that I had to be confident. I didn't know what to do with it. So going through, you did an excellent job of having a simple, straightforward message for us. You applied. You provided audience examples that really captured everyone here tonight. What I would say improve on is in your preparation. Making sure that as you look through, focus in on when you're writing that speech, you had the examples, make sure that they're there in every position. You could have added one more in there between transitioning with getting us all energized, and then how do we take that energy and apply it to our own lives? The last part of that would be the, it would be looking at making sure that here would be a prime example. I'm doing it myself. You had great pauses where you stopped to let us think. You had pauses, however, where you also made us wonder, how prepared are you? So also making sure that you have that speech down. So Beth, you provided us with the confident Beth during your speech, and you also provided us with a little bit of humility. So we know that confidence is 90% mental and 10% preparation. So thank you, Beth. Madam Corker.
First person on our panel who will go through analytical quality is Jerry Evans.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster. And Eric, solid, strong opening. You got straight to the point. You didn't waste any time, didn't mince any words. You engaged Beth right away, looked at her, then you looked at the audience, then you go right into demonstrating her stomping her feet, talking about all her strong points. So you have a very commanding, very strong, very assured voice that serves you well in terms of your evaluation. You got specific in terms of beginning to end, talking about audience engagement, audience adaptation. And then I liked when you got into, I would have liked to have known. And then you gave her specifics about what she could improve on. Preparation, examples, transitions, all strong points. How do we take that energy? She had great energy, you had great energy, you mirrored that and match that up to some of the things that she spoke about. And you gave strong recommendations in terms of focusing on her strengths, and to wrap it on a nice neat little bow, you did a great summary, which I'm sure will be commented on. But overall, I think that your strongest qualities in your evaluation is just your confidence, your energy, your enthusiasm, and you got straight to the point, didn't waste any time at all.
Great. Thanks, Jerry. Val, can you give us your analytical quality?
Eric, you identified some of her strengths, some of Beth's strengths, right in your opening, which instead of having just a regular opening, you identified how she was strong, what made her speech strong. So you did two things at once. And you demonstrated how her strengths were effective to the audience, which I liked. Walking up forward, how she looked, how she embodied confidence to the audience. And then you talked about, you gave examples of what was not effective in your opinion, and how she could take the topic about confidence and how she could make it apply to the audience more effectively. So I like the way you did that. You were focused, you gave some good recommendations, so the presentation was effective, that I think she can take away some good ahas. For recommendation, I would say that usually the speaker is going to be in the front of the audience. Have a little more eye contact with the evaluator instead of just the audience. I think you've spent more time looking at the audience than at that. So I would concentrate a little bit more. You can move a little bit and say a couple of words towards the audience, but I think effective to her would be to really have more eye contact with her. But it was a great presentation, a lot of energy and good points.
Great, thanks, Val. John, you want to give us some recommendations?
All right, let's look at your recommendations, Eric. I liked that you offered some very specific and very practical recommendations. I liked that you picked up on a weakness in the transitions in Beth's speech, and this is, I believe, the first of our evaluators who picked up on that particular opportunity to improve, so I think that's a good thing. What I was missing, and maybe it's me, it could be that by now my listening skills have diminished a tad, but I'm not sure I heard really strong connections between the analysis that you gave in the early part of your evaluation and the recommendations. A couple of them, I think, were connected to your analysis, and then I think a couple sort of came out of the blue at the end. And that just, to me, felt a little disjointed.
Great, thanks, John. Nick, would you like to give some more recommendations?
Yes. Eric, one thing that you did that I think that I really liked is you gave a little bit more insight, because as the listener, when someone's giving a speech, they want to hear, well, I want to use this information. And beyond the vocal variety and kind of the fundamentals of a speech, you want to get to that. And I think your insight into, well, I was sitting there and I wanted to learn how to use this information tomorrow, I thought that was very good. To John's point, you mentioned preparation and being prepared to the speech. It seemed to be blurred between your second and your third point, where it kind of became one point. So I would just be careful either to mention it once or kind of separate it into two and say where it became disconnected at different parts of the speech.
Great, thanks, Nick. All right, John, would you like to give us technique and summation, please?
Certainly. Eric, a couple things that I picked up right away is that you showed in your evaluation that you really paid attention to the speech by using some of the words that Beth used, crescendo. The cringe, you actually used the same body language that she used. So it showed that you were really paying attention, and I felt that the evaluation was going to be spot on with that paying attention there. The summation, I didn't quite catch a whole lot of it. I don't really have a whole lot to say, so I'm just going to stop right there.
Okay. Amy, how about you? You want to give us some more technique and summation?
Sure. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and Eric. Eric, first of all, some of the things I noticed about you as a speaker is that you have a very positive, motivational style, which instantly drew me in, because that's something that I think we all want to hear when we're listening to a speaker. You also have excellent gestures and your whole body movement, your usage of the stage area. So when you were delivering your feedback to Beth, I know it probably came across as praise to her, which was excellent. That's what you want to do, especially during your summation. Some of the areas that I thought you might want to take a little bit of focus on to make your evaluation even more effective. Number one, it seemed towards the end, and I was kind of watching the timing cards, but it seemed like you almost kind of rushed through that last component when you were trying to give her some constructive feedback of what she might improve upon. And then it seemed during the evaluation, you also seemed to focus on Beth, which is very important, but maybe look at some of the audience members again so they might pick up on some of the feedback that you were giving to them during the evaluation. I also noticed throughout your evaluation you gave a little more on the positive side, maybe try to balance it with a little bit more on the constructive side about some areas that Beth can improve upon so that she can, again, take those as tools to make her evaluation more effective next time. Thank you.
Great. Thanks, Amy. Okay. Next up to evaluate Beth is Emily Horowitz. Emily?
Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, guests, and especially Beth. Hello. Beth, confidence. This is something that my friends and I have been talking about a lot lately, especially where we have little young siblings and cousins that are being bullied in school. So confidence has come up a lot, and this was a great topic to hear about tonight. And while I love the topic, what I want to talk to you most about this evening is your technique and your speaking skills. There's a few things I listen for as I am an evaluator and listen to your speech. I'm looking for body language, listening for vocal variety, and paying attention to the audience and within myself for audience engagement. So all the comments I have for you graze along a lot of those different areas. The opening. The most important thing to me when evaluating a speech is listening to the opening. Even when I'm just an audience member, I need to be drawn in right away. I'm one of those people with undiagnosed ADHD, and you need to get my attention now, otherwise you've lost it forever. You came out here and your vocal variety was amazing. It was a strong voice right away, and you had me pulled in. Except for one little thing. Your body movements didn't mimic your voice. At first you came out and the voice was very strong, and I expected this grand gesture of confidence. and we didn't get it right away. But we did get it eventually, and Beth, I know you have it in you. We saw it multiple times throughout the speech, where you have the ability to come up with these big gestures and to engage us and have lots of strong body movement. I'd love to have you do that right off the bat to get us 100% engaged right away. The vocal variety I listened for continuing throughout the speech, and not only just the grand gestures, but the little things, the little conversation pieces throughout it. And we were missing something conversationally. The speech was pretty well memorized, but we could tell it was memorized, which took away from it feeling like it came from your heart. And confidence is a very personal thing that we struggle with, and we need it to come from the inside. So I'd like to suggest that maybe you record your speech while you're practicing and listen to it, and it'll sound more conversational as you practice, and that'll help with those misplaced pauses that you heard a little bit about tonight. I'd also love to hear a few more personal stories. As I said, confidence is a very intimate, personal thing. And we'd love to hear more, whether it's about you, your personal struggles with building confidence, or your son. Love to hear more stories about how we can build from that and what you overcame. One last item that hits a lot of these points that I've wanted to touch on is your position, your movement along across the speaking floor. Really embrace it and use that confidence when you come up here, and to have those strong movements, stay there and use them. Don't back up too quickly. It's okay to back up, but make it slow. In summary, you are a very talented speaker with natural strengths, but I'd love you to embrace those talents for gestures especially and vocal variety. Keep your smile and your positive energy, and most importantly, be confident. Madam Toastmaster.
Thanks, Emily. First out of the gate, we'll have Val Fuson doing analytical quality.
Emily, thank you for your presentation, your evaluation. I wanted to go over a couple of things. You have a very nice structure for your evaluation. You identified some strength, well, the importance of confidence. However, I think you went into vocal variety and then how it didn't mimic what she was talking about. And then you were talking about to be more conversational, and then she should have more personal notes. I think that you were identifying more weaknesses right off the bat instead of more strengths. So I would have point out some things that she does terrific first, 2 to 3 things that are terrific, and identify why they are. And then you can go into, I like the way you had your vocal variety was strong. However, then identify how she could have improved that. And you identified vocal variety twice. So I would say just maybe do it once and then have some other, go into more detail on the personal stories or to be more conversational. So you're pointing out some of the things that she could improve on her speech. But I think just to make it a little stronger would be to let her know what works really well right now and why, how it would affect the audience if she expanded on her strengths. So one of the recommendations would be to identify more strengths. And then you also, in the recommendations, you said but. Sometimes when we use the word, I like how you're dressed, but you could have dressed nicer. So you have to be careful with the word but. So I would say use the word and, or you could improve, it could be more effective. So look for another word for but. And that would be something that would make your presentation a little more effective for.
Great, thanks, Val.
I know, I was the offender. I started it.
Jerry, you want to give us more analytical?
Emily, there you are. I liked when you came up, your opening, your organization and your structure. You approached it a little bit more casually than some of the other evaluators this evening. So you kind of get a little bit different approach to the evaluation. I thought that was good because that sort of set you apart from perhaps some of the other formats or the way people were evaluating. And then you started with, this is something my friends and I have discussed, so relating something personal to you as related to Beth. I listened for, then you started talking about body language, vocal variety. And I think that giving her those examples and pointing that out, what she did well, I would agree with Val somewhat in terms of you were kind of doing it in a roundabout way instead of really focusing on her strengths. And then, you know, be more specific about that, to focus on that. And you talked about personal stories. So give her an example of a personal story, because you started out saying this is something my friends and I have talked about. So give her an example beyond that of a personal story that you can use to strengthen that. I did like your summation. I thought it was a good summation. I think you could have punched that up a little bit more. But overall, your summation was good. And I think your approach to it was a good, strong approach in your evaluation.
Great. Thanks, Emily. Nick, you want to give us some recommendations?
Sure. Emily, one of the things I liked about your recommendations is you actually covered a lot. You covered body language, structure, technique, vocal variety, personal stories, and positioning. So you gave her a lot of feedback, which was good. To kind of mimic what Valerie was saying, there's that technique that I don't like to use, but that sandwich method, where we follow a negative and use a positive after that. So some of your, for example, you mentioned that you would have liked to have seen some more personal stories, but Beth did use one. So it was something along the lines of, I liked your personal stories, I would have liked to seen more. But other than that, I thought you did a good job of covering a lot of areas.
Great, thanks, Nick. Now, John,
yes.
You'd like to add some?
All right, Emily. I counted four recommendations. Improvement to body movement, recording speech for practice, use more personal stories, and embrace the stage. All right. The first two highlights the practicality and usefulness of the recommendations in your evaluation. Very strong. The third one, using more personal stories, and then you gave an example. That, I thought, was particularly practical. The fourth recommendation, embrace the stage. Connect the use of the stage with the subject matter of the speech. And I thought that was brilliant. That was very insightful, because with a talk that's all about confidence, the speaker should definitely have exhibited confidence in using the space. So I thought that was a particularly insightful recommendation. Where I would look for some improvement for you is I would actually either lose or condense the personal connection thing, the little story you told about discussing bullying with friends, in order to give yourself a little more time to be a little more expansive about the recommendations.
Great, thanks, John. Next, we'll have Amy giving us technique and summation advice.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and Emily, I see you right there. One of the things that I really admired about you right away when you came up to speak is that you have a very sincere, warm style when you're delivering your evaluation. And so I admired that, and I also really admired your courage, because you gave some praise to Beth, but then you also right away gave her some constructive feedback about when she first came up and she was talking, but there was a disconnect between what she was saying and some of the gestures. So I like that you jumped right into that recommendation to her. The other thing that I enjoyed is that you gave some feedback to her that I haven't heard other people say, and you said, record yourself. It's rare and far and few between that I hear someone make that suggestion, so I liked how you thought outside the box during your evaluation. Some of the areas that I might recommend to focus on would be, first of all, your eye contact. You did look at Beth, but there were a lot of times I watched you, and you kind of were looking into space. Maybe it's because you were collecting your thoughts, but I would caution you that, because it might come off to people as though you're not sincere. That great sincerity you've got in your personality, when you're not looking at us, we're kind of wondering, what's she thinking about? But one of the things we also do in Toastmasters on purpose is we try to hold our eye contact with someone for 3 to 5 seconds. So I challenge you to try to do that for your next evaluation. And then the other thing is your voice, maybe a little bit louder, because I'm up front, I can hear you really well, but if it was a very large room, I think it might have been difficult to hear you at the back of the room. Thank you.
Great, thanks. Good job.
Good job. I'm in trouble.
Emily, I'm going to bring up just two real quick points. Your technique, you mentioned the personal story, and whenever I hear the audience member tell me how a speech I gave touched me or made me think about a personal, I feel motivated and excited because my speech touched you. So I thought that was a very good point and very beneficial for Beth to hear. Secondly, your summation, it was good, it was thought out, but it was very general. And if you could get more specific on that, that would add a little more meat to the summation of the evaluation.
Great, thanks John. Okay, our next evaluator for Beth, I almost got to, is Jerry Evans. And Jerry, of course, is from Toastmasters on Purpose. Jerry.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and especially Beth. Three great strengths of yours. Strong, confident, coming out to talk about confidence as ours. Positive, specific, helpful. Good use of questions. I like you brought in Jack Palin. Some of the audience may not be familiar with Jack Palin, so you might want to use a more relevant example to kind of bring us into the 21st century, even though I love Jack Palin. Control, certainty, confidence. When you were talking about control, confidence, and certainty, when you were speaking to us about that, I'm not so sure that some of your body just was necessarily matched up with that, because you want to exude that confidence. And you were talking about that, but it didn't come across, I think, naturally. It was almost like not contrived, but somewhat rehearsed. And depending on your prep time in this, and then you ask us the question, what if certainty control came along because we act confident? So we act as if we're confident. So let your body language speak those words so that they're all congruent with one another. I liked how you pulled in the story about your son, and someone else mentioned it before, like a polished statement, even though he was jelly inside. I think that was a golden opportunity for you to talk about how you really felt jelly inside, because especially we as Toastmasters and as speakers, we all have that jelly inside, even though externally we may appear to have that confidence. But sometimes it's more not artificial, but it's not really genuine and sincere. And I think that that was an opportunity for you really to let you, Beth, come out and fill up the space that you're engaged, fill up the space that you're in to engage the audience. Some of the other evaluators have talked about use of the speaking area. I know this is probably about halfway through your CC, so some of the things that perhaps were mentioned aren't necessarily applicable to you. I liked how you engage the audience by talking about an exercise. That's a great way for any of us to engage an audience, and I think you did an excellent job with that. I especially like when you had us do the exercise. The difference would have been, someone else had mentioned it, stand up to even get us more engaged. And your energy and enthusiasm was excellent with that. So the three actually recommendations that I would make is to let your natural enthusiasm energy come across and let your confidence come across. Some of that might be just a question of you preparing a little bit more, so it comes across as more organic and more natural versus more rehearsed. And secondly, is to let confidence work for you and use your personal story and how confidence, perhaps either in your past or present, and how you can be more confident and use that personal story to really get that point across. Madam Toastmaster.
First, we'll have Val Fuson doing analytical quality. Val?
Hey.
Jerry, I like the way you came out right away and had a lot of energy. Your presentation was very clear. You first identified her strengths, some weaknesses or areas that she could improve on, and then went back to her strengths again. So I like the way you identified that. At the beginning, you came out and you said, I'm going to talk to you about three strengths. But then I heard strong, confident, pastor-specific, positive, specific, helpful. And so, 1, 2, 3. So if you're going to say numbers, then only say those three. You can add them later, you can add more later. But I would say go into more, you know, strong, confident, and then positive. And then identify why they were. What was strong about it? What was confident about it? Why was it positive? And you talked to her about exuding more confidence, act as if. I think those were good points to talk to her about and let her know that she also has to exude the confidence, you know, when she's on stage. So I think the way you did it, strengths, weaknesses, and strengths again, and you identified quite a few strengths, which I think could help her improve her presentation. And then you gave her areas of what areas she can improve on. So it's good evaluation.
Great, thanks, Val. Jerry's not going to have to give us his analysis on himself. We're going to go right to. We can talk to him about that later.
Self-analysis.
And Nick, would you like to give us some recommendations to Jerry?
Jerry, I thought you gave good evaluations. You always give a lot of heartful and a lot of meat and potatoes kind of evaluations, and I thought you did that tonight. You started, you talked about 3 points, but there was a little bit of confusion there because you mentioned the 3 points, and then it seemed like 4, 5, or 6, and then you were kind of building on sub-points of what you have already said. So I would just try to separate that into body language and energy and specific points that you want to talk about. And at the end, it kind of happened again. You said, you know, use your energy, let the confidence work with you, and then it kind of went off a little bit, and I think we may have lost that last point. So lots of meats and potatoes there, just kind of separate them and just be more specific.
Great, thanks, Nick. John, do you have some more recommendations for Jerry?
I do have some things to say about Jerry's recommendations. And I'm going to pick on Jerry a little bit because he's a friend. Your recommendations were specific and useful and practical, absolutely dead on for where Beth is, as I perceive her strength. I really liked the use of the word congruent when you were discussing that there were times when Beth's body language or gestures were congruent with what she was saying and other times when they were not. So I just like that image that things need to be together. And so there's a really clear, good use of words there. I like the fact that much of this evaluation is very concise, very clear. And I like that a couple of your recommendations were about kicking up her strengths a little bit rather than simply focusing on things that were less strong about the speech. And here's where I'm going to pick on you a little bit, but only because I haven't heard this from anybody, and I just wanted to be sure that I hit on it, is I've yet to hear anyone make a recommendation about content and how the speech is written and structured. Most of the recommendations have been about technique, and yet if you look at the judging form for the humorous speech contest or the international speech contest, content is nearly 50% of the value. So it's an important thing to do is to pay attention to the speaker's content and how it's developed. So that's my thoughts.
Great, thanks, John. Amy, you want to give us some technique and summation advice?
Sure. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and most importantly, Jerry. Jerry, some of the comments I thought about and I jotted down as I watched your evaluation is, number one, you are a naturally advanced and motivational speaker. So instantly, I know that when you gave the evaluation to Beth, she probably felt positive. I sure did listening to you because you just have that natural style to be positive and to put a smile on our face. I liked it when you gave that evaluation. You also did reference motivational speakers, which I thought was interesting at the same time. You did an excellent recap and summation, and I liked at the end how you tied it up by saying the first point and the second point. It just kind of made that easy to follow along. Some of the areas I might suggest to focus on is the eye contact, and I feel like I'm kind of picking on everybody tonight, but maybe it's a layout of this room, but I did notice that you, again, looked a lot at Beth, and again, maybe, you know, a couple points, look at some of us in the audience as you're making a point so that we know that we're still connected with you. And then also the sandwich technique I wrote down, it was sometimes hard to follow you because you would say something as far as positive feedback, and then you go to constructive, and then you went back to positive, and I might suggest sectioning that out a little bit more so it's easier to follow for the audience. Thank you.
Great, thanks, Amy. John, you want to add some technique and summation advice?
A couple things that I noticed, Jerry, in the technique is that you had a lot of great points to give to Beth. And in the time, maybe limit to 2 or 3 so you can develop each of those points a little deeper. Instead of just touching a surface, maybe give her a little more meat and potatoes to the evaluation. And because you had so many points, it was going to be hard to summarize all the points and just maybe cut down the number of points that you'd be giving.
Great, thanks, John. All right, our final evaluator for Beth is Nick Belenfano. He is also one of our newer members of TOP, and he's also here at Harper College. So, Nick.
Thank you, Madam Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters guests, and especially Beth. Beth, I really enjoyed your speech tonight, and I'd like to give you some pointers and some tips of improvement for next time. I thought you did a lot of things well. I think you chose a topic that we all can relate to, confidence versus uncertainty in our lives. You had a power statement, I am feeling confident. You had a formula, control and plus certainty equals confidence. You gave us tips. Stand with your shoulders apart. Breathe. Use your power pose. Then you even talked about like a thought process for don't go into the big battle. You know, use small victories to kind of gain your confidence. So I thought you did a lot of things well in the sense that your content gave us something to connect to. But in the spirit of Toastmasters, I'd like to give you some tips for improvement. I think this speech could come off as an informational speech, but I think there's a great opportunity for a story. And the story here is a story between two characters that we all have. It's between our confident side and our uncertain side. And I think you could have more dialogue using fundamentals of Toastmasters as you give your speech. For example, vocal variety. I am feeling confident as you tell the speech versus I wasn't feeling so confident. And then you could use the stage. When you have that confident character, use big strides, take up big space. And then when you're not feeling as confident, take little steps. And then body language. The highlight of your speech is when you got us all to raise our hands because you were demonstrating that confidence, but we connected to it. See, I don't think you need to get rid of the uncertain character or the uncertain part. I think if you have a certain contrast between the two, the speech could work just as well. Because it's not about the confidence part. It's about getting all of us to see that in us, we have both of those sides. We want to have that confidence side come out. But other than that, it was a great speech, and I look forward to your next one.
All right, so if my records are correct, I believe that Val, you are first again with the analytical quality.
Nick, I liked your evaluation. You came out and told her what you were going to cover, and then you went into the strengths, the confidence. You talked about her power statement, the formula and the tips. I believe you're the only one that talked about the formula, and she had a couple of different formulas. So I think that was good, and that would, whenever you can say something different than most of the speakers are going to give, that's going to help you stand out. You also talked about her weaknesses, the two characters, so she could have two characters. So you tell her what she could improve on when she already is telling a story. But how she can improve that story. how she could structure it differently. And one way would be through the dialogue. So I think, you know, letting her know how she can restructure her story to include the dialogue, to include more body language in it, and to include, identify the characters, two characters, can help her build her speech to be more effective. So I like the way you did that, and then you, I think you could have gone, recommendations, you could have gone into a little bit more about the formula, why it was effective, how it impacted you, how it could impact the audience, and either the confidence or the power statement. Again, I don't think anyone else covered the power statement, so that's something else that you could expand on. The idea is to pick out one or two things that is more specific, more unique than general. And in picking out how to structure her speech, how to structure her story, could be very beneficial. So I think your presentation was very effective.
Great, thanks, Val. Jerry, do you have something you'd like to add?
Thanks. Madam Toastmaster, Nick, you came right out of the box. You were very straightforward, because in your evaluation, you don't mince your words, you get right to the point, so I like that. And then you came right away. I thought you did a lot of things great, Beth, and you identified what some of those things were. Specific points. You gave her some tips and suggestions, and you gave her examples that I think were practical examples. It wasn't esoteric, it wasn't hypothetical, something that she could actually apply after she gave her speech this evening. And you talked about, you thought her speech were perhaps more of an informational speech, but you like kind of the yin and yang of confidence and uncertainty, and you said she could construct that or format it almost like in a personal story when you gave the example of talking about vocal variety to exude the confidence in her speech. The speaking area, in terms of, you know, giving her examples of that and the body language part of it, I think that's part and parcel of it, but I think your tips and suggestions were the stronger part of it, because some of it's beyond the level that she's at right now, and we all have a tendency to focus on some of those things, but your energy level was very clear, was very concise, was very precise, and I like the fact that you brought dialogue into it, and that's been mentioned very few times this evening. And then telling her personal story, which I think Beth was suggested to her before. I think you pointed that out and talking about the characters of the story, I think that was a real strength of your evaluation.
Great, thanks, Jerry. John, you want to give some recommendations?
Yeah, let's talk about recommendations here. I caught two strong recommendations. I hope I didn't miss anything. The first was, we have an opportunity for a story here. And then the second was, consider using the fundamentals of Toastmasters, things we're all familiar with, such as vocal variety and body language and so on, in order to amplify your examples. I liked both of those. They're practical and useful. They were, I liked that you looked for ways to improve the speech from a structural angle. I liked the connection with Toastmasters. Funny thing, right after I say that nobody's touched on structure and content, here Nick used 80% of his evaluation to focus on structure and content. So the biggest weakness was almost no attention paid whatsoever to speaking technique. So we do have to have a little bit of that.
Great, thanks, John. Amy, how about some technique and summation?
Sure, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and Nick. Nick, first of all, some of the things I appreciate about your evaluation style is that you are analytical and you have a sincere way of really getting into the minute details that draw us in. You also seem to be very relaxed up in front of the group. So when I'm watching some of this relaxed, I feel like I can kind of take a breath myself, and I'm looking forward to what you're saying. And I know that for the speaker, that's a benefit, because they feel as though you are giving them the feedback in a nice way that they're going to take in and probably accept that message a lot better. I also like something that you did. You said, in the spirit of Toastmasters, that caught my ear, because when you're giving someone positive feedback, then you're going to start moving over towards those constructive suggestions, you've got to kind of weave those two pieces together, woman. I thought that was an interesting spin on words. I like the fact that you also had a nice balance between positive and constructive feedback in your evaluation. Some of the suggestions I might make during these summation and also in your technique is that relaxed component is awesome, but maybe a little bit more power when you're getting up in front of the group so that you're pulling the people in the back of the room into your talk. And also, you had suggested about to do a little bit more gesturing and that, and I'd like to see you do a little bit more of just opening it up and using that speaking area more as you continue to do your evaluations. Great job. Thank you.
Okay, John, wrap us up here.
Okay, real quickly, Nick, a couple things that your examples for Beth were great for Beth, and also I think for anyone who's giving a speech, because they were very specific and they can be used for any type of speech, and I thought that was a real strong point in your evaluation. I liked how you said the speech as it was held was a very good speech and it worked, and then you gave an example of how it could be amped up even more by using that confident versus non-confident story confrontation, because I think we all do have that battle going on inside where some days we know we're going to knock the world over, and then there's other days where the world, well, knocks us over. And I like the way that you brought that out.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. I know we're all tired. It's been a long day, so I want to very quickly thank everyone, especially all of our evaluators. I want to remind you that you can always visit TOP. We meet on the first and third Wednesday of the month right here in this room at Harper. We have a website, and if you look at Keep Your Flyer, you can see how to contact us. Doesn't make any difference what level you're at. You could be giving your second speech. If you want to come to TOP and give your speech, you won't get quite this many evaluations.
Sure.
You'll get 3 plus a round robin. So it's a little more than you would get in the club. We don't do table topics. We don't do some of the other things. We focus on speeches and evaluations. If you would like to join TOP, we would love to have you. You need to be in another club and have completed your CC to join, but you're always welcome to visit. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned a lot. I wish you all well in your area and division contests. I also would like to remind you that prior to the table topics and international speech contest, we will be doing a similar workshop for table topics. So with that, I will turn it over. Oh, I'm sorry,
yes.
Iqbal.
Yes.
He took such care of taking time. Would you like to give us a quick report?
I would be honored to be on the Toastmasters. So the target speaker for tonight, Beth Reed, the timing of her speech was 6 minutes and 20 seconds.
Yeah. Good.
And for the evaluators, Kathy Vanderstock, 3 minutes and 2 seconds. Paul Lockwood, 3 minutes and 5 seconds. May Lee, 4 minutes and 44 seconds. Eric Hattenhauer, 2 minutes and 52 seconds. Emily Horowitz, 3 minutes and 20 seconds. Jerry Evans, 2 minutes and 56 seconds. And finally, Nick Bellantuono with 2 minutes and 18 seconds.
Excellent. Great
right.
job, everyone.
And how was Beth's time?
It was
six minutes and 20 seconds.
Okay. All right, does anyone have any quick questions? And of course, you know that you'll be able to access this. Tim, you want to give them another quick?
I'm not going to give a thing, but I felt like it was doing America's Got Talent. The only thing I could recommend is, wouldn't she look great in an evening gown?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have one quick question. All night long I've been hearing everyone talking about that when they're giving their evaluations that people they're not at this point yet, well, they're not here, well, I want to know, how do you determine when a person is up there giving a speech, how do you determine where about they are among going through their competent communicator book?
That's the challenge of a contest.
I mean,
you don't know
yeah.
the speech project that they're on.
Okay.
You know that they probably have not done their CC yet.
Right.
Although I have to tell you, I was in a division contest where the person was well beyond her CC. So it is very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't rely on what you always see in the book that you normally
right.
follow. You have to go with the general pieces that everyone has been talking about,
mm-hmm.
their technique,
the use of vocal variety, gestures. Right, they could be at their second speech and maybe they don't need to hear that, but they need to know for the future, okay? So that's always the challenge.
That's a real
you have to go
thing
with
there, right?
You have okay. to go with everything that you've learned in the CC manual and pick out those pieces that you think apply. Sometimes you can tell by how nervous they are or you know the type of speech, but really typically
I think we all are aware, if they're not, it's between someone who's given their second to sixth speech.
Well, I was gonna say between your fourth
so
and
that's,
sixth.
So that's the range from the second to the sixth speech.
Okay.
Yeah.
Basically, you can tell based on the kinds of opportunities for improvement that you see, just where the most likely low-hanging fruit are for the next most pertinent, appropriate improvement.
And let's face it, everybody starts in a different place. So you could have a person giving their second speech who has done a lot of presentations, who does really well. We will not pay any attention to the people at this table. You could have somebody else who might be on their ninth speech, but because they had no prior experience whatsoever, they still have a lot of room to grow. So you just have to go with what you see, what you feel, what you want to take home. Yeah. We would like some feedback from all of you.
Did you find this helpful?
Yeah. Perhaps we had a few too many evaluators. what do you think? Because we want to do this again in the future.
Okay. I have one comment, and that was I love the fact of, thank goodness, you know, he gave us an intro of what judges are looking for in the contest versus maybe just a regular evaluation. Mm-hmm. There was one point where I did get a curveball, which was making sure that about half of the evaluation is content versus speaking technique. And I was looking through my notes, and I guess I just missed that part of making sure to highlight content versus speaking technique.
Right, and again, I don't know if that's as much in the evaluation contest as it is in a speech contest, is it?
That's correct.
Okay.
What I was doing with that point was simply illustrating that in judging a speech, and in essence, that's what your evaluation is doing. You are saying, against the ideal, here's how this particular speech stacks up. And a good speech is well organized, right? And it's all of that. And so I was just trying to make the point that there should be some attention paid to content, as also some attention paid to technique, because both elements of the speech are important.
Right. So he was doing that as far as doing the evaluation, not as far as towards the judge judging your evaluation of their speech. I know, it gets confusing. That's why there's separate forms for each of the contests, because there's always a little something different.
And this is the first time, I think, and John probably has researched that, but I think this is the first event of this kind that's ever been done in the district, because there's been other types of special events, but nothing specifically focused on evaluations, and so it's new for us trying to format, because as Bridget just said, in the future we're going to be working on one that's going to be a special event for the international, and then for table topics. So it's an opportunity for all of us to learn from one another, to share those learnings, and then, you know, as we do different events, or maybe some of your clubs do different events, you know, we can kind of share that knowledge.
Okay. So just to be clear, I just want to make sure I understand, John.
Yeah.
You're saying that make sure that you do touch on both content and speaking technique in a good balance between the two.
Okay.
Right.
Well, the content would be the organization,
right. The
structure of it, storytelling, were they effective in structuring the story? And if you look at the judge's ballot for a speaking contest, you can see that that's broken down into 3 points, which we don't have on here, but if you could look at that to see how a speaker would be evaluated. So you want to cover that content. It's what? Content?
Content, development,
technique, delivery.
And delivery.
Okay.
Those 3 points.
And if you don't have access to those forms, you can always go on the website, on the D30 website. If there is an actual spot there for all of the contest forms. You want to see the actual judging criteria for the humorous speech this time or for the international speech.
Great.
Any other thoughts on our evening together? Did you enjoy?
Yes.
Love the food.
I thought the evaluations of the evaluations were very helpful. I thought they were perhaps a little long. I think based on the time that was allotted, that perhaps, you know, I know initially it was said that there'd be about a minute per person of the six. I think it may have been a minute and a half to 2 minutes per person.
Yeah. It was.
So perhaps trying to do a Reader's Digest condensed version of an evaluation of the evaluation may be better, especially if you're going to have two people addressing the same aspect anyhow.
Yeah.
We're going to work on that.
Okay.
What about also the number of evaluators that you had? I thought that after the third, getting into maybe the fourth, I just started kind of getting this idea that it was just starting to become very, very redundant.
Yeah.
People had time to sit back, listen to what others had to say, kind of change it up a little bit. It's like, okay, well, this point was covered by this person, this point was covered by this person, and this kind of got, okay, we get the idea. I personally found the most valuable part, I mean, I loved all the evaluations, don't get me wrong, but just learning about the contest, your stuff, as far as, this is kind of how it's broken down. 71 seconds for this, you know, 50 seconds for that, 29 seconds, here's the most important part. I think that's the stuff that was the most important, because you know, when you have a brand new person like myself who has no idea of what's going on, I at least now have some ammunition to go, okay, I can walk in there and I know really what I need to focus on.
Right.
I can keep away from the ball at the very beginning, go straight to the point, and hit it.
Yeah.
You know.
Thank you. Just to have to, not so much to defend, but just to explain, our intent was to try to involve as many people as possible, so we decided if we could figure a way to get about 10 minutes for 8 or 9 people, we recognized that it was probably going to start to get redundant. But we also anticipated that some of the later evaluators would be picking up on some of the coaching that they had heard, and I think we did see some of that.
Yeah. Just listening to the other evaluators and just little nuggets that you can pick out, you go, okay, I could do that. So again, kind of a work in progress.
Yeah. Well, thanks for the feedback. Yeah. Emily?
I found that to be a really big challenge to have all the evaluators in the room.
Now you know why they do it the way they do it in the contest.
I'm looking back, but I can't believe I just said all that. But I found that to be very jumbling in my head. And I've done a lot of evaluation contests, and we're never in the room to hear the other evaluations. And it totally messes with what you were going to say. My notes look so great, and I don't know what came out of it. It's because I was hearing everybody's voices in my head. My only suggestion would be, because I love that we, those of us who like to compete and get better at this, want to do that, to have all the evaluators give their speeches and then have your panel talk after.
Well, that's interesting.
Just a thought, because I benefited from hearing all of your evaluations for everybody else. It was hearing everybody else that made me go a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay.
That way it also doesn't become so redundant, too.
Okay.
Maybe you had a question.
I think this is great format. I personally benefit a lot. I appreciated all of the input. I have one recommendation. Is, are you guys going to take this kind of training to other divisions?
I don't know. Probably not.
We're selfish.
We want people to come to us.
Part of it was too, is that before you came here tonight, how many of you were aware that there were dance clubs?
Well, big bomb, please.
Okay. So part of the audience.
All right.
Right. So probably what, 40%? 40%? So our intention, as John said, was twofold. I mean, we wanted to use this format and see how that worked in terms of helping people, getting as many people as possible to evaluate and then get the feedback in that. But also just to bring awareness to advanced clubs and how they differ from your regular club. Because if all of you, and some of you have been, of course, to top already, is that format is different than their regular club. And they get a different type of evaluation. Some people think that, oh my God, I come to top and it's going to be intimidating and you'll rip me apart. Not at all. Because when they come and they have that experience, they find that it's very Iqbal the first time he came, and I'm sure, you know, just like when we go to a Toastmaster Club for the first time, the experience is completely different. They go, wow, this is really cool, because we've had people come to give their icebreakers and get feedback on it. And the other, there's only now three, excluding Windy City, there's only three other advanced clubs. That's it. And we have over 4,400 members. Okay. And 200, you know, roughly 40 clubs. So we're trying to kick it up in terms of our club, because we know there are a lot of excellent Toastmasters that would really benefit from this at whatever level that they're at, especially working towards your CC. And then once you get your CC, I mean, it can take, for all of us, it's taken it to a whole different level.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I just wanted to add, so one of the things that I'm very appreciative about this event is the fact that most of the people that have heard about this event are specifically coming because they want to prepare for the evaluation contest.
Right.
And I, as division governor and as a Toastmaster, I think that that is ideally placed. Now, I've come to this club before, well before the contest season, and like Jerry said, it is a mind-blowing experience because you've gotten so used to this. And as a speaker myself, you know, I want to have that opportunity where when the evaluation, when this contest season ends, I want something that's going to be there to help me continuously raise the level, raise the bar.
Okay.
And so having this evaluation round robin and the evaluation portion strategically placed now, very good, excellent timing, very well preparatory for those individuals that are very concerned and very focused on the evaluation contest. But I know that this is actually just like the stimulus for what's going to come after the contest season ends.
Right.
So I like it. I really do.
Okay. At this point, we're going to have to end soon.
Yeah, two.
Yeah, we're
going to
get kicked out.
Very, very quick ideas.
Yes.
One is 150 seconds. I was focused on that and thinking, I've got more time than that. Really, I mean, I'm not going to get
until...
Well,
you have 1 minute and 30, so it's actually 210.
Yeah, it's more time than that.
Yeah. Good catch.
The other thought is that, you know, spread the word to all of the clubs that are in the division or whatever that the video's out there, so that prior to the contest, they can watch what they saw tonight. So that, make sure that everybody gets a link out to all the club presidents and let them see this, because it may help prepare people on the people who are here.
Okay.
And Tim has been great about getting, because when he records stuff for the district, I don't know if you're, all of you are aware of that.
Yeah.
If Tim didn't do what he did, we're the only district in the majority of regions that even do video for these type of things.
Right. The only district in the world with this much comprehensive coverage. Let's get this event ended. I'd like to get her final thoughts on comments, and then let's wrap it up, please. It's getting to be long.
Yeah.
Okay. What's your thing?
I thought that this was a great event. I didn't quite realize what I was signing up for. This is my second target speaker opportunity. I have another one tomorrow and another one Tuesday. So So I only practiced this speech. I finished writing it yesterday afternoon. So I greatly appreciate all the feedback that I got. I greatly appreciate that I got feedback from folks who are pretty much at my level and not from you guys. So I would say absolutely do this again. This is fabulous.
Okay,
all right.
Great. And you're always welcome to visit, as are all of you. So safe driving, and we hope to see you at our meetings.
Thank you all very much.